تقي يا دكتور جميل.
انا هقدم روحي، انا هقدم نفسي. مساء الخير يا جماعه، انا اسمي دكتوره جيليه مختار. التوب بتاعتي اسمها اوكسيديتيف ستريس وانتي اوكسيدنت ان ثلاسيميا، وهي ما كانش ميعادها النهارده، بس انا يعني عملت نوع من الفيفر، ويا رب تقدروا ان انا الفيفر بتاعي ده كان للمصلحه العامه. الموضوع بتاعي يمكن هيبقى تبع الثلاسيميا، بس في جزء يس كله انجليزي. تفتكروا وهم يهمهم يعرفوا؟ خلاص. So my topic will be about oxidative stress, antioxidants in thalassemia. But actually I'll make it broader than being just thalassemia. This is my agenda. What, why, and how? So we have to reply. What, why, and how? What? What is oxidative stress? What are the effects on the blood elements? Why oxidative stress in thalassemia? What are the mechanisms? And how to prevent this? These are my three aims and three questions to have this balance. Number one is what? The oxidative stress is what is normal in our body. In our body, we have the process of oxidation ending by free radicals, and these free radicals are needed. We have to have these free radicals for many things, for inflammation, for eradication of infection, for many, many things. But still, it has deleterious effect on the mitochondria, the DNA, and the cells. So if the amount of the free radicals are exceeding the normal balance, this will be the oxidative stress. We have the oxidative stress associated many, many conditions. This is just in brief many of them. Some of them: chronic fatigue syndrome, inflammatory process, fibromyalgia, diabetes, Alzheimer, anxiety, insomnia, and cancer. So, what are the oxidants? This is number two in what? What is oxidation and what are the oxidants? We have two types of oxidants. One is in our bodies and one is coming from outside our bodies. In our bodies, we call it endogenous. And this happens with inflammation, with chemicals, etc., inside the body. But outside the body, there are irradiation, there are the chemicals we are exposed to. But we have on the top of the list iron. So I put it separately, like one of the most important oxidants coming as exogenous. Why oxidative stress in beta thalassemia? Why? Is it the usual to have this such oxidative stress? No, there are some conditions in the thalassemia body that makes the oxidative stress more. One of them is the alpha gene. And we know that we have a alpha globin. We know that we have a lot of this alpha globin. This is always oxidized. This is always forming what we call hemichrome. This is always forming what is hemin, and all end with the excess of the free radical formation and the reactive oxygen species with the end result of hemolysis and ineffective erythropoiesis. This is number one in what is the cause or why in the thalassemia there is excess of oxidation. Number two is the iron. I told you about the iron as being exogenous, but here it is endogenous. There is excess iron overload, and this with the excess of more forming labile oxygen species with the end result of damage. This is how the non-transferrin bound iron causes cellular dysfunction. The usual pathway of the iron is this, but in particular we have this. In beta thalassemia we have excess iron with the cellular dysfunction, with the apoptosis and more of the necrosis. This is in particular in thalassemia. So we have two conditions. Number one is the excess alpha, and number two is the excess iron. We have many things to say about this excess iron, and the end result is the glutathione reduced. The more the platelets are activated, and the more the damage is. So because of continuous blood transfusion, thalassemia patients are subjected to perioxidative tissue injury by the secondary iron overload. We all know about the metabolic functions of the iron. The iron is a good carrier for the oxygen, as for the hemoglobin and myoglobin. We know it is a good productive of the energy by the cytochrome and mitochondria. And it is important for recycling, getting the DNA produced, and the recycling is getting rid of the oxygen species. So here is the pitfall that happens with excess iron, that there is no recycling, but there is excess damage by the oxygen species. From this, before, we know that we can use the iron chelator to reduce the oxygen species in some inflammatory process, already done in rheumatoid arthritis, in inflammatory process, by using this ferrite. This verifies that the excess of the oxygen species is causing inflammation, and iron is responsible for this recycling. What is the effect of the oxidative stress? What will happen for the oxidative stress? Number one is cellular damage, cellular oxidative stress. Number two, red cell damage. Number three, inflammatory process. Number four is vascular dysfunction, and all end up with tissue injury. In the blood components, there is effect on the RBCs, effect on the white cells, and effect on the platelets. This is what happens on the RBCs. It causes hemolysis. This is what happens on the platelets, as mentioned through all thrombotic events with Professor Dr. Mona and Professor Dr. Osama about thrombotic event, as the oxidant effect is responsible for activation of the platelet with the end of thrombotic formation. How do you know if you have oxidative stress? I think all of you just now have oxidative stress, because all of you feels fatigue, and this fatigue is due to oxidative stress. Memory loss. You remember the first session what was about, so you don't have memory loss. The brain fog, muscle and joint pain. We are all limping. Wrinkles and gray hair, not for females. Decreased eyesight, all with the glasses. Headaches, sensitivity to noise. You cannot bear what is noise, including my voice. So I try to make it susceptibility to the infection. And this is, how do you know that you have oxidative stress? And what the oxidative stress will cause in your body? Just tell me any part of the body is exempt. No part of the body is exempt. Starting from the brain, the heart, the kidney, skin, other organs, joints, immune system, blood vessels, lung, and eyes, all are affected by the oxidative stress. This is not for thalassemic only, this is for all of us. And how to prevent? So if we know that this is very dangerous to have such an oxidative stress, you have to prevent. So this is number three question: what, why, and how to prevent? Of course, by antioxidant. There will be a scale. One side is the oxidant, and the other side is the antioxidant. What do the antioxidant do? they give the electron, the pre-species electron donation, and accordingly it will be balanced and no more oxidative stress. Do we have any endogenous? Yes, sure, antioxidant we do have. Superoxide, dismutase, catalase, glutathione, peroxidase, ferroxidase, ceruloplasmin, haptoglobin, albumin, uric acid, all these are antioxidants. ربنا مديهالنا نعمة جوانا. And we have to improve this by exogenous antioxidants. Like now they call it selenium ACE, and this is very known drug now all over for the skin, for the eye, for the antioxidant selenium A, C, and E, of course, with others like zinc and other things. Why in thalassemia there is such an overload? There is already consumption of the antioxidant. We don't have enough antioxidant in thalassemic patient, and this by studies, they found that there is decreased ascorbate, vitamin A, vitamin E, carotene in thalassemic patient. Again, they found that the selenium already is low, and selenium is a very important part of the protein which are responsible for antioxidant like glutathione and many others. This is here the role of antioxidant, how it acts along the whole cell. And one by one, vitamin E. Vitamin E is the well-known antioxidant. So how to get it? How to get it? From nuts. Nuts, as بالليل, حبت سوداني, this needs not to be in English. If you want to, nuts, this is known. And oils, of course. And this is the sources, and on the top come the almonds, sunflower seeds, the oil, sunflower oil, etc. زيد عباد الشمس واللب بتاع عباد الشمس والحاجات دي اقعدوا ازقزوا فيها بالليل النهارده. And again, this is the sources of vitamin E. Vitamin A, it is very well known beside other things like the healthy skin, the eye, the vision, the neurological function, but again, is very important antioxidant. So where to get vitamin A from? On top is any color, vegetable or fruits, they have a lot of vitamin A. Anyone with orange color, you can consider it as vitamin A. The carrots, the pumpkins, the pepper, the bell pepper, the colored pepper, the apricots, the whatever is yellow in color, you can use it. But of course, the liver is one of the important sources, and the spinach, again, is one of the important sources. Folic acid as antioxidant, this is very important again. Now they call it vitamin B9. It's not simply folic, but it is called vitamin B9. And of course, you need it in thalassemic patients, besides the other values of the folic acid, including thrombosis. Dr. Mona, Professor Mona, folic acid can prevent thrombosis as well as antioxidant in such instance. Where to get vitamin E, folic acid from? The folic acid, you can get it from green leafy vegetables and legumes like and lentils and beans, الفول والعدس والحاجات اللي هي حبوب. This is plenty of folic acid. Vitamin C, again, we have many, but the most important of it, many functions, the most important is antioxidant, and you all know where to get vitamin C because this is very popular and very famous. Never forget vitamin D, and vitamin D as an antioxidant is known. Although the last year I had a lecture about vitamin E, vitamin D, with many purposes, but here I can add that it is well antioxidant. And this is the ways, 12 ways to get your vitamin D, including the sun. Vitamin K. Vitamin K is still an antioxidant, and you can get it from leafy vegetables. Selenium is very important, mostly because it reduces the reactive oxygen species, and this is just to tease you that the highest source of selenium is in Brazil nut. Can you get it? No, I cannot get it, but it is plenty with selenium, but we still have the eggs, the mushrooms, shellfish, and meat with enough selenium. Zinc, again, is very important, and we get it in oysters, and we get it in beef, and we get it in shellfish. Here is the many, many types of antioxidants, but again, to tease you that the most powerful of it is chocolate, the black chocolate. So who are fond of chocolate, you can use it liberally. But the next to it are berries, strawberries, blueberries, whatever. التوت اللي كنا بنعرفه زمان ده واحد من الحاجات بتاعت الانتي اوكسيدنت المهمه. وشكل الاوكسيدنت الانتي اوكسيدنت بتبقى كده كل ما هو colors whatever you can eat with colors you are eating antioxidants. وده الفانكشنز بتاعت الانتي اوكسيدنت. بس انا حبيت اوريكم الصوره دي. Never ever overuse the antioxidants. يعني it is anti-aging, but not to that extent. مش هينزلوا لغايه ما يبقوا عيال لان هم اخذوا antioxidants because they took a lot of anti-aging. It will not help like that. And this is the father of medicine, Hippocrates, who said that let your food be your medicine. I have just two or three slides about what is the best antioxidant. You think, what is the best antioxidant? It is the alkylator. This is the best, although you are helping with food, but still the antioxidant is important. And to use judicious blood transfusion with not overload with blood transfusion and splenectomy and avoiding complications is important. The last thing about heard of earthing yet? سمعتوا عن الواحد يمشي حافي؟ Earthing. The effect of earthing is antioxidant. This is very important. Earthing, to have bare foot اللي احنا عمالين نتخانق مع اولادنا عليهم, just let them for some time to be barefooted. This means excess antioxidant. And they have this scientifically. Scientifically, there is evidence about this that the barefooting helps the free electrons from Earth. لا ما هو على على أرض الرمل وعلى أرض الطريق بس مش الأرض اللي وسعة مش نجيبة. This is the effect of earthing. This is the antioxidant effect of earthing, and we come to the conclusion that oxidative stress plays a role in pathophysiology in thalassemia, and the use of alkylator plus the antioxidants, either separately or in combination, has a significant role in the treatment of thalassemia, and the balance of life is the key. The balance is the key of life, and thank you so much.
Thank you. My eminent professor, Galila.